It's rather chilly evening. It is a Monday. Yes, I hope everybody went through their weekend just fine. Mine was, it was okay. It was okay. Anywho, let's delve into what happened in the world of celebrity while I was away. Do you know what's so annoying about this here right now? Is that when the morning came, I was so pumped. I was so excited. Now, I don't know if all of you saw it, but it was on social and on different YouTube channels. Now, apparently, a certain TV station came out, broke a story about Joe Steady, how he has a baby mama somewhere who he's not helping. He's being a deadbeat dad. I was pumped. All the fires were in me and within me. I was pumped. And then I was seeing the feedback on social media. Oh, the feminists were ranting. The women on Mama Tendo were like, what now? Whew, it was intense. I was ready. But you know, we are very objective journalists here at New Vision. So we had to take our time. Now, one thing y'all didn't actually understand about this story that broke. We got the story first. I think sometime, Farouk, like about Easter time. So we got the story, the chick came out, gave us her allegations, we got her on camera, but then we had to first go and ask him, like, dude, what's up? Now the whole story is, this chick came out, she says, I had a child with Joe Steady, mbona abona, tanyamba, buliwe mkubile simu ne mugamba, mpaku sento, mwana mluade, ampayo mtualo gumu, mwankola bwenti, omwana tamla bididanze, ndi wano honjo zango yeza kukalo, omtumbi gwango yezu nungu nangenda guole za kanana. She met, like when you watched it, you would be like, what in the world? So we're like, uh-huh, so what happened then? What changed? Because you've been doing this for 2 years. And then she goes like, and then I saw he had bought his chick a car. I was like, oh, your plot thickens. Mm-hmm. Nenyiga nyore. It went back and forth. So this TV station goes and runs that story with just her version. We, on the other hand, because we're smarter than that, we reach out to him. Now, according to Joe Steady, he says, hold up. I don't know the heifer. I don't know her. I ain't never seen her. Okay, did he say it is never seen her? That is the part we're still trying to understand. Anyway, so just that he goes and he's like, no, I'm going to sue whoever let this run. This cannot go on. This is defamation. Now then, you know, gigi wange ku weekend, but I don't know the chick. Now, when we go back to the chick, this is when I was like, these women, eh? But now it's so mesabana, sinja kukoma kwecho, tu so mesabana. We finally reach out to her and we're like, okay, wait, pace it, slow your roll. Tell us. Mm-hmm. She's like, Kati, anyway, according to her, she claims, but it seems Abasajja bali banji, right? Like she was sleeping with way too many men. But according to her, she says, Joe Steady is the father of the child. According to the sources and the different versions she's giving us, it kind of looks like this chick has a guy who almost looks like Joe Steady. Now, digging deeper into that, Farouk just gave us like the craziest now on that one. He's like, there is a guy, Josh. Now this could actually be the real father of the child. Everything. Now this Josh guy is actually the baby father. If the dust settles down or if she's just being confused. This Josh guy apparently also even goes around booking for performances, Muzendi Josh Steady. So I think Josh Steady has like a doppelganger somewhere. But the chick says one time he came over to see her and then she was like, sick we're going to have a good TV. And then that guy, we don't know if it is Josh or Josh Steady. At this point, we don't know. That guy is like, oh, yagalani. Oyagala waku TV, obo yagala aliwano. Chik nagamba aliwano. It's all right. Nechikuatagana neva connecting. But this story, though, has got so many loops. Sibitegeta. First of all, Joe Steady is coming out and complaining, these people have ruined my name, I'm going to sue, he's mad, and I understand that. But let's ask ourselves a very sensible question, because he has agreed to doing a DNA test, because the woman said, if you want to prove me wrong, let's come and do a DNA test. She's that confident. She says, call it DNA. Joe Steady goes like, no problem, I'll do the DNA test. But again, Micah Small thinking, Omusajja tayitiranga ko wantu If you know you have not slept with a certain chick in Masaka at this time during these dates, you don't know her, you don't even remember what she looks like, why would you agree to a DNA test? That is already suspect. It gives me probable cause of like, maybe this chick is not crazy after all. Perhaps she knows something. Now, we're trying to push Justin to explain to us that bit. Have you ever slept with the chick? Have you ever seen the chick? Do you know the chick? Because we are tired of these artists who come and become deadbeat fathers just because they go and get these unsuspecting village girls. Things are in almost everything. There is no class, there is no standard. Sometimes the baby mamas that come out and say this, I had a baby with this person, wait. Where did y'all even meet? How did y'all meet? You get what I'm saying? But anyway, so we're waiting. He says he's going to do the DNA test. I'm laughing. I am honestly laughing. But he says the reason why he has agreed to do the DNA test is simply because he's trying to clear his name. Because the entire weekend was rough for him. He could barely perform. He stayed home, which means he's losing money. I'd like for us to take a moment and take it all in. Farouk, what's your say? Is the child his or not? Judging from both the stories, you've been in the field with us. From both stories. Yeah? Farouk, be clear. Chikolachi? Chisawoka. Willis, what's your take? According, she says they met in 2012. And in 2012, there are chances that yalia chali mboko ngensita namukuba. Okay. Nga msanganga kusho. Willis, what's your take? You don't know? I never trust an artist. I know that. We never trust these artists, but sagala kumusaba. You get what I'm saying? Because, I mean, Justin is now just trying to enjoy his new phone. It's like new phone fame. Because he came out a while back. We didn't pay him that much attention. But now he's coming into his own with his own music. And he's making money. He's buying baby mama's cars. So I want for us to be very objective with this one. Farouk says, Chisoboka. Willis also says, never trust an artist. I say, it's very, very possible. But I'm waiting. I'm going to sit back pretty and wait, sip this tea. I hope they will come out. Let's flip the script. So what if the DNA come out and it's his child? Can we then crucify him to a wall? Like, you didn't understand the state and sight of what this woman looked like and what she was going through. I would crucify you in this life, the life after the next, and the one to come where you could probably be reincarnated. I would do that for you. Free pass. Now, Katulinda, DNA together, Di Farouk. Today? It's supposed to be today. This week. Hi! That happened in Celebrityville. Politics, politics, politics. It will bring out the best and the worst out of the regular people that we know. So apparently, not just rumor, it is not rife, it is the truth. Chameleology, aka Toleta Minzani Ndimunene. That guy, yeah! Can someone count for me how many times that guy has changed his religion? Simanyicha anonya, anonya type, what type of God? Wawa yanga mbichaka waliwe misambo na mijini ya jimu londula. Buliwe jimu kupa mwe miswaiba jomwa, kanga dayonga alokoka. Because Chameleon was, they were Christian. Then natola shahada na asidamu ka. Na vayo mbusidamu. Then natumulaba kufu 77 dogs. That's the revolution that came with all artists going to the 77 dogs. I don't know if it was a PR stunt. I still believe it was. And then after the 77 dogs, now tuliwa Pastor Manjeri. First of all, Manjeri is still, she's still running a church in this here country. Wow. Wow. Lovers of reggae music and lovers rock and all that music, I honestly don't understand. Don't get me wrong. To each his own. I would rather listen to metal than try to understand reggae music. I just feel depressed every time I listen to reggae music. I don't know why. But someone could say the same about hard rock metal. Anyway, for all of you in the country that enjoy that, guess what? Guess you what? Now, Buju Banton was just freed. Oh, everyone was like, yes! He was an icon, a sensation. He was all those things. To be honest, his history is good stuff. So, Buju Banton, Morgan Heritage, what's the other guy's name? And Beanie Man. Listen to that. Buju, Morgan Heritage, Beanie Man. Now, I don't love reggae, but I love one Morgan Heritage song. And I loved all of Beanie Man's songs. I don't know any Buju Banton song. I look like a dumb fool, don't I? Anyway, they are coming to town. That's what I was going to say. Yes. Now, they have a charity organization. They're going to be coming into town. They're going to be selling tickets. Muje Mugule. It's all to support a certain school in northern Uganda that has over 500 students. And they're going to be giving out what? Scholarships or bursaries? Which one is it? To particular kids from different universities. It's a good drive, but that is not even the part we are looking at. As an entertainer, I am looking at the showdown. So they are going to be where? Wanogu cricket over, wanobagenda kujuza way back. And of course, you know where the conversation will lead to during the show. I was just telling people, get your money ready. Get your money ready. Buju Banton is coming your way. He's coming with Beanie Man. He's coming with Morgan Heritage. I mean, it's to die for. If I can just help us. Eh? And they pepper in someone. It's only Chameleon and Bebeko. That's a good show still. If I have Beanie, if I have Buju, if I have Morgan Heritage, between those three, there's way too much music. Would have to listen to it for like 6 years. Back to back for it to get done. Then you have Chameleon and Bebeko who have the same situation. It's a good show. We'll talk about this and a lot much more during the course of the week. My name is Tinafius1. Don't forget, at Tinafius1 is my Twitter handle. Thank you for the follows on Twitter. Thank you for the likes. It's overwhelming at times. 3 years into this, so much hate, so much love. I still love this shit. I do. At Tinafius1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and at Tinafius1. Not forgetting, on Instagram at Tinafius1 with an H. I'll catch you again tomorrow. On the flip side, I'm out. Peace.